Okay.
So let me kick off. I mean, I suppose we've got about 6 or 7 minutes. Can I just start off by asking you, stage are you at?
My name is Yousef. I am a second year PhD student in chemical engineering. Okay. And my area of research is basically the reaction engineering and catalysis of hydrothermal gasification and hydrocarbons. The idea of my project here is to convert oil wells into hydrothermal reactors where water reacts with the oil and the hydrogen to generate the hydrogen, as well as extract or desulfurize the oil and to clean it.
So this is to generate a source of hydrogen?
Yes. Yeah.
If you're meeting the man on the bus to explain this, what's the basic idea here? We're moving towards hydrogen.
Basically, a shortcut towards towards the hydrogen economy.
Yep.
A clean way of producing hydrogen straight from the salt, and also minimizing the environmental impact coming from the consumption of crude oil by many of the world's largest economies. This environmental impact is primarily now due to the CO2 emissions. So that's the main motivation of our project. Moving towards the hydrogen economy and minimizing the CO2 emissions.
And one final general question, and then you can give me a more detailed explanation.
Yes.
Which would be when you go into a PhD exam, and the examiner says, what have you done that's new, hasn't been done anywhere else in the world? What could be the key novel aspect of this?
The key novel aspect would be developing a hydrothermal flow reactor where the oil reacts with the water. Okay, and the hydrothermal conditions, supercritical water, which is still being had the gravimetrification across the scientific community, for the property of supercritical water, and how we can produce the hydrogen as a favorable gas ratio, remove the sulfur in a flow reactor system.
All right.
That's the key novel of this system. Okay.
Nobody else is doing that around the world, to your knowledge.
Yeah.
And you have to keep an eye on that for the next 14 months as well.
Even if there's somebody doing it, I found, for example, in Saudi Aramco, I just found somebody that has patented a process similar to my process, but they're looking at it from a different angle.
All right.
They are more motivated towards upgrading the oil rather than producing the hydrogen.
Good. So you're going to tick the novelty box, and you're keeping an eye on what everybody does.
And there are some other aspects which I still keep.
All right.
Yeah, which I'm sure nobody would... There will be a difference, and we strive to make our process more innovative and more cutting edge compared with others.
So tell me a little bit more about it, and tell me what the main achievements and challenges have been.
Okay, all right. So the first thing was to design and construct the rig necessary to study the salt First of all, the reactor system has been designed in a flow system where we inject the oil and the water in a quarter of an inch, being placed inside the furnace here, and throughout this small tubing, the oil and the water react in high-pressure conditions, and then they flow to a condenser to bring down the temperature from 36 degrees Celsius down to 20 degrees Celsius, and then they flow to a phase separator where the gas is being separated to the gas analyzer, while the liquid residue is contained, the oil, the water, and the emulsion, then it's collected and analyzed using a GSEPS.
I do mass spectrometry for a living, so I'm interested in this bit.
This mass spectrometer basically identifies the gas being produced based on the molecular weight, because the gas flows there basically gets fragmented, it gets bombarded by elements and then gets fragmented, and based on the fragmentation we can identify the gas being produced, and we calibrated it so that we can also quantify the gas and distribute it. We also measure the gas flow rate using the bubble flow meter. Based on that, we can do a carbon balance, how much carbon is produced and how much product is obtained. Based on the mass balance, the resistance time analysis, we can model our chemical reactions. We also do some functional analysis, multiphysics analysis, where we study the fluid mechanics in the reactor, where we are the transition from flow, turbulent, and then another flow, and under what condition, as we need to transfer in the reactor. And we try to maintain the isothermality of the reactor based on running a log load velocity and basically having a better preheating of our water as well as your, so that our reaction temperature is basically uniform.
And I've read this as you've been talking actually, and so overall, this is your PhD, but standing back from that, do you think this technology is going to be viable?
Absolutely, and that's our challenge, is to make it viable.
Right,
that's
you think you've got a good chance.
Environmentally, it's very attractive, but economically, that's what we need to find out.
Okay, so it's expensive compared to just digging the oil out of the ground.
Yes, with the capital investment to gasify the oil from underground, it'll be worthwhile or not.
Right.
And if it is not worthwhile, how to make it worthwhile by optimizing the reaction?
Do you think it will be worthwhile in the next few years, or is this something for 10 or 20 years?
A few decades.
Okay.
Because one reason is the hydrogen economy is still at its early stage.
Yes.
Yeah. So, and one nice thing about this process is that it's not necessarily towards the hydrogen. Towards production of hydrogen, but can also produce oil cleaner fuel. So currently, we are basically achieving simultaneous production of hydrogen and fuel, so that we can meet the current demand of energy.
Very good.
You see? And if we are shifting slowly or gradually towards hydrogen coming in the next few decades, this process will even be better and it will be more viable to you.
Thank you very much. So you can record that comment.
Thank you very much.
It's a very exciting project. I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much, Dr. David. I am very much